Welcome to the 29th meeting in 2022 of the Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee. I'd like to remind members present to switch your mobile phones to silent. The first item of business is to decide whether to take items 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 in private. Is the committee content to take these items in private?
Yes.
Under agenda item number 2, we're considering two instruments subject to the negative procedure. An issue has been raised in one of these instruments, which is SSI 2022-326, the Scottish Child Payment and Ancillary Provision Regulations 2022. The instrument makes ancillary provisions in connection with the amendments made by the Social Security Miscellaneous Amendment and Transitional Provision Scotland Regulations 2022 to the Scottish Child Payment Regulations 2020. The instrument was laid in draft under the affirmative procedure and came into force yesterday. In correspondence with the presiding officer, the Scottish Government acknowledged that it is the second SSI breaching the 28-day rule that has been required to seek to ensure that the draft affirmative instrument works as intended. In respect of this latest instrument, the letter states that it was necessary to breach a 28-day rule to address further issues that had been identified. The short timescales are required to deliver the policy intent and ensure that the required provisions come into force at the same time as the substantive provisions in the draft affirmative instrument. Under section 28.2 of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform of Scotland Act 2010, instruments subject to the negative procedure must be laid at least 28 days before they come into force, not counting recess periods of more than 4 days. This instrument breaches this requirement as it was laid on the 8th of November 2022 and came into force on the 14th of November 2022. Does the committee wish to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament on reporting ground J for the failure to comply with loan requirements? And does the committee wish to welcome the Scottish Government's apology for this breach, while nevertheless indicating that it considers it to be unsatisfactory that this is the second amending instrument breaching the 28-day rule? In particular, does the committee wish to call on the Scottish Government to ensure that its quality assurance processes are sufficient to ensure that subordinate legislation laid before the Parliament is fit for purpose? Yeah, thank you. Also, under this agenda item, no points have been raised on SSI 2022-310. Is the committee content with this instrument?
Yep.
Okay. And with that, I'll move the committee into private. Thank you.